Hello.
It's August 20th. You know what that means. It's my darling's birthday. Happy birthday, darling. She's 1 year older. Isn't that wonderful? All right. Texas is hot.
What about Arizona?
I'm not worried about Arizona, especially since I'm not there. Thanks for your turn signal, madam. Since I'm not in Arizona, your family is in Arizona, not Texas. Somebody run over this thing. Still, it's a celebration, and while we celebrate, we have to think about those who perished in Cameroon in that accident in America. And interestingly, not interestingly, coincidentally, when I passed there Friday morning, there was a truck, a semi. I just went over right there at that hill before you get to just before supermarket. And I have seen many accidents there just in the last 2 weeks. Three nobody died. There were three accidents there. That did not make news. Complain about the roads. I am not doing that. I'm complaining about these guys who call themselves road safety individuals who do nothing but look for money. Imagine me driving a Tacoma and being harassed for an hour for money because I did not write there that the Tacoma is so many pounds in weight and carries five people and the engine number is blah 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 blah. That's what they worried about. They did not worry about my brakes working. They did not worry about if I have turn signals that work. They did not worry about if I have brake lights. They did not worry about my shock absorbers broken. They were complaining about this, me not writing that thing. And I showed them a truck that just went by and it was leaning like this because it had a broken shock absorber, yet they were allowing it to go down the street with load that was almost the same height as the truck itself was from the ground to the edge of the cabin. These are things that safety people should be checking. Yeah, they do check for fire extinguishers, they check for chocks for your wheel, tires, and they check for a medical kit, which is okay. But the efficiency of the truck itself, they never worry about that. You have cars that really, from the junkyard in Europe, being shipped there, and they are flying the highway. I mean, these are cars that people have thrown away. God, thank you for taking care of us. Honestly, it could be worse. The roads, yes, you can manage. Slow down your speed and drive safely, yes. But when the car you are operating is not safe, doesn't work, things do not work well, I don't care if you are on a highway like the one I'm going to get on. It will not make a difference. Your equipment is, the car is not working properly. cry every time I leave Cameroon. I actually do cry. What can I say? Okay. My sympathy to the families who have lost families there. The kids who are going to go hungry now because mom or dad or cousin or niece or nephew who was going to Douala, uncle who was going to Douala to buy small things to come and sell and feed the family is now gone. What will they drop on and do? Nothing. Nothing. Hey, or replace the lives of 20 people. And is there any insurance that will even pay anything? I mean, you're killed, you're gone, you're just gone. That's it. You're dead. Talk about in some other countries, you know, the insurance company for that car will pay for medical bills for those who are not killed. But in Cameroon, you're dead, you're done. Your family has to bear the cost of funeral, and funerals in Cameroon are very, very expensive, believe me. People want to compete with the other people about making a big show of the funeral, feeding hundreds of people, buying a truck full of alcohol, when they don't even have anything to eat. So I feel for them. Anyway, we're here, we're going to meet the rest of the family and find a place. Let me let you guys out here. Let me let you out. You're right at the door. Mama, go. Go. What should you day, and it's being hosted by my ex-wife, who is somehow standing over there. Let me park.